got it, show. Children, stand standing. Audience, have a seat. Turn around. Now, third grade. No, I was children. Stay standing. Third grade, you're going to do your recording piece, and then we're going to sing Purim songs. Are we ready? Big hand, everybody, big hand. Okay. All right, now, if you have a song to children, hold it to the Purim Play song, where we mention every 8th grade name and their role in the Purim Play. Moanat, are you ready? Crisco, are you ready on the drums? Give me a drum roll, Crisco, come on. There you go, let's go. Sing nice and loud, let's go, everybody, go. Singing is number one. In time is perishing, no one's begun. May ready. A nipple in my nipple. Tamea umbadea. Aloha pa ambashana. A volle tarea. La la. Ucho e chave tu fa Dabu dabba velo yadu Ucho e chave tu fa Dabu dabba velo yadu Ki imaranu e Ucho e chave tu fa Dabu dabba velo yadu Ki imaranu e Ate ate lo yada Ate ate lo yada Let's go. La Yehudim Aita, Ohave Simcha, Ohave Simcha, Vesason Vika. La Yehudim Aita, Ohave Simcha, Ohave Simcha, Vesason Vika. Take a bow, everybody, take a bow. Somebody, make them your parents, everybody. Go, go, go. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Can I sit here? Can I sit here?
Find a seat, find a seat, find a seat.
Find your parents. Find your... Okay, everybody. Everybody, find a seat, stay there, the show starts. Do not cross the light in the middle. Please sit down, no bleachers, please. Nobody sits on bleachers, nobody. Put your hands together to the 2024 Purim Play Shoot Shingle. Thank you.
is Corona, and I'm a friend of the Jews. Welcome to Shushan. Never heard of it? Let me paint you a picture. Once upon a time, there was this magical kingdom accepting of all customs and practices. However, some people less friendly than yours truly would eventually climb the ranks and oppress the smaller groups, such as the Jews. One family decided to try to hide their child from this horrible environment, and so they hid their beautiful daughter in a tower. Unfortunately, they could not join her, but her uncle Mordechai, a real master of camouflage, you might say, was able to raise her in the Jewish customs. Esther stays in her tower to this day, but she might be realizing that she's interested in a little more. Meanwhile, the town is alive as ever. Just an old dress code compliant. Hop the bus and by then it's like 7:15.
And so we love this town. We're all so glad we're here. Living in Shushan, yes, it brings us joy and cheer. We stand up as proud Jews, not giving in to fear. Here in Shushan, our lives begin.
The lunch room full of the shoes and shots on. Playing the synagogue and candle lighting. Then we'll sing, maybe swing some sublime. We're so glad
we'll play some Gaga strong
if we have time to spare.
This town we love to wander everywhere.
And then we'll walk to the shul and end it all with prayer. Loving the same place we've always been.
And we'll keep singing and singing and singing and singing. The Shushan, our lives begin.
There sits Esther, still in her tower. She's been there. Man, I've lost count of how many days it's been. I wouldn't even Swiss to calculate how many days it's been. I know she fears the minister, but what does she do up there all day?
Toys and sweets till the floor's all clean. Dolling then do laundry and mop and china. Sweep again and by then it's like 7:15.
And so you'll read a book and then you'll take a break. You'll break the collar then you'll put it into bake.
I'll play guitar and knit and decorate this cake.
Just wonder when will your life begin.
After lunch, you'll do Moriah's Hebrew. Study the PowerPoint for more malicious tests.
Finish my math and make myself multiple ball soup. Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch, take a climb, so dress.
And you'll reread the books if you have time to spare. You'll find your vocab book, I'm sure it's here somewhere.
And then I'll brush and brush and brush and brush my hair.
Stuck in the same place I've always been. And I'll keep wandering and wandering and wandering and wandering. When will my life begin?
Every day I'm filled with such fear, thinking about all the hatred out there. Haman's so cruel, she hates all the Jews. So I stay up here and avoid her short views.
I'm the great and noble Maximus, the king's greatest ally. You cannot outrun me.
You're right, but how's your climbing?
No!
Ow, did you to sing with that frying pan?
Who are you and what are you doing in my tower? Nobody comes in my tower.
I didn't know anyone was here. It looked abandoned. The vines I climbed looked so golden and brittle, so I thought they were old.
That's my hair.
Your what?
My hair. It grows very long, very quickly. So my uncle cuts it for me and then places it around the outside so it's easier for him to climb since he's getting older.
Oh, I thought you meant that you were draping the hair on your head out the window. That'd be totally weird.
I mean, I used to let it grow that long, but I was told it's not hygienic. According to the Torah, my uncle Mordechai, it's good to keep a proper hygiene.
Sounds like a wise man. My name is King Acha, Flynn Ryder. I'm sorry to barge in through your window. I'm running from... Well, it's a long story. I just have to stay long enough to know that no one will see me on my way out. Do people often come this way?
People, you're the first person I've seen in years, other than my uncle, of course.
Do you not leave the tower ever?
No.
How is that possible? Who are you?
My name is Esther. I've been up here basically my whole life. I was told there's much to fear out there, but I hear the music and I see the beautiful lights. Where's that coming from?
That's Shushan, the king that tries to make all of his people happy. It's a shame you've heard otherwise.
Shushan, someday I'd like to go there.
Well, what are you waiting for? A written invitation?
Haha, perhaps. I need to speak to my uncle, of course.
Alright, well, it looks like the coast is clear, so I'm gonna get out of your hair. Now, let's do this again, but without the frying pan.
Oh, right. It was nice to actually meet someone for a change. Every day, I'm filled with such fear, thinking about all the hatred out there. But now I know there's some good to see. Will I keep hiding, or will I set myself free?
Back at the kingdom, King Flynn's lifestyle frustrates Queen Vashti, who's beginning to boil over with anger. Connor reminds me when we go out to carpool before we're called. Man, does that upset Dr. Bahar. Anyway.
Maximus, have you seen Big Ton and Terrace recently? I'm worried. They're normally back then after our adventures.
Not recently. I thought I saw a couple who looked like them the last time I pursued those troublemakers, but it couldn't have been them. Ooh, is that them now?
Hey, there's our mighty king and stallion.
My king, I think we need you to come with us on another adventure.
Yeah, we think you're going to want to see this.
But my king, you have all these people to entertain. I can prance around for a little, but they're here for you.
I know, good step in. Where's my queen? She's great at filling in for me. She could put on a full dance performance. We'll never even notice that I left.
Again? She didn't seem too happy the last couple times you ditched her to entertain everyone while you ran out.
Nonsense. She loves the spotlight and attention. Everybody knows that she didn't marry me for my charm. This is the only reason that she stays around. Vashti!
Yes?
My queen, I need to turn out again, but I'm having this party.
A party? That sounds fun.
Oh, it'll be so much fun. Everybody will celebrate your very presence.
Okay, that does sound fun, but wait, you're not going to be there again?
Oh, I just have to pop out for a bit, but I'll be right back. Meanwhile, I think you can put on one of those dance performances that everybody loves.
What?
You know, a dance for the party guests?
You know what? I'm done. Don't make an early dismissal.
What do you mean?
I've had it with you running out on all your endless selfish demands. This is not what I signed up for.
Told you so.
I want something that I want.
any more adventures anytime soon.
You're really gonna let her get away with that? Is that wise for a king to do?
Come on, you know that no one has ever referred to me as wise. That's what I view for her.
Very well, Bitch on a Terrace, take her away.
Ah, get away from me!
Meanwhile, things are brewing in Shishan, and I don't mean coffee. While some people believe we should all just get along, others don't exactly feel the same way. Yep, that's right. I'm talking about Haman and her bestie Zeresh. They've hated the Jews for as long as I can remember.
Ugh, what an eyesore, Zeresh. Can you believe it? Another synagogue.
Kippahs, get your kippahs, come get your kippahs.
No.
Kala, call me for some kala.
These Jews are everywhere.
Seriously, they spread like roaches, even though they have to do what we tell them. I'd so just rather they weren't here at all.
Little do they know I forced them to bow down, so I don't have to look directly at them.
Oh no.
Yep, it's time I was there again. Let's try to ignore them.
Maybe if I just...
Look over there.
Too late, they spotted us.
Mordechai, Harbona, not trying to blend into your surroundings again, are you? Remember what we discussed?
You must bow down at once!
Haman, as I've told you multiple times, I do not bow down to anyone but God. I mean no disrespect, but I will not change my mind about this.
How dare you! Don't you know who she is? Don't you know what she can do to you?
Zeresh, hush. Mordechai will get what's coming to him.
Come on, Haman, Zeresh. The Jews and Persians can live in harmony as long as we respect each other's cultures and beliefs. I mean, I'm not Jewish, but I'm a friend of the Jews.
That's just not the way it works around her, Harbona. I'm the king's minister. I have power and prestige. Who is Mordechai? He's just a poor Jew with no respect.
Harbona, let's go.
Zeresh, something must be done about Mordechai.
I hear you.
He's been a thorn in my side for far too long. He refuses to bow to me. To me, the second most powerful person in Shushan.
I can't believe it either. You command respect.
That's precisely the problem. I deserve that respect. He's just an insignificant Jew, and yet he defies me at every turn.
This Mordechai is a stubborn one, but haven't you tried everything already? Erecting gallows, seeking the king's approval to hang him, and so on?
Yes, but all my schemes have failed. The king has other concerns on his mind, and Mordechai just always seems to slip through the cracks. It's infuriating.
Well, he can't get away with it forever. He'll get what's coming to him.
Indeed, he will.
Wow, Haman and Zeresh are not happy. We'll keep an eye on those two. Meanwhile, back at the palace, the king also seems less than pleased. Looking at him, you'd think he just missed field day.
My king, you look bored and blue. What's going on?
Oh, I feel like I have nothing anymore. Nothing that excites me.
I know what you mean. That troublemaker has gone far too long, and I have no exciting to chase anymore.
I still can't believe that Vashti dumped the king.
You know, if I were king, I wouldn't have trouble holding on to a woman.
I'm going stir crazy in this castle without a queen. I crave adventure, and some company would be nice. I don't know what I want, but I need something.
Something that I want.
Carrots! Always make me feel better.
Maybe take a vacation?
Ooh, I hear Club Shushan's nice this time of year.
What? No, I need a new queen. But not like Vashti. Maybe one who I actually like this time, who likes me too.
Oh, gotcha. But how do you get a new queen?
Hey guy, how are you doing?
Fine, thank you. I'm here to do Vashti's hair. Know where I can find her?
Not here, that's for sure. King Flynn gave her the food. Kind of like a 7th grader trying to join the forum play.
Does that mean I'm out of a job?
No, not at all. Actually, we were just talking about how I could get a new queen.
I've got it! A pageant! Have all the yellow girl women in Shushan come to compete for your love. It'll be like the Shushan version of The Bachelor. That'll surely have that troublemaker pay a visit as well. Everybody wins.
A pageant! What a wonderful idea. Big Ton Terrace, arrange it at once. Send out invitations that will fly to all corners of the kingdom on those celebratory glowing lanterns. This shall be a celebration.
Right away, my king. Does that mean I'm doing everyone's hair?
see what kinds of characters show up for the pageant. In the meantime, let's check in with Esther, who's... Ah, yes, of course, still in her tower, where she's been a long time. Here comes her Uncle Mordecai.
Esther, sweet Esther.
Where are you?
Here, Uncle Mordecai, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm feeling curious, actually. I had a visitor earlier.
A visitor? What do you mean? Get down here.
Come in. Yes, a real-life visitor, and I had him square in the face with a frying pan, just like you told me.
Oi, babe. Is he still here? Did you tie him up like I taught you?
No, he didn't fall asleep like you thought someone would, but he turned out to be safe, and even more, he told me that the kingdom is safe. And after he was done waiting for, well, I don't know what he was waiting for, but he politely left, and he told me he hopes to see me again. Ugh, I'm so confused.
Well, you have been stuck in this tower for much too long, my dear Esther. Perhaps you'll finally allow yourself to venture into Shushan, go shopping, get a haircut.
Definitely not. I mean, maybe. Ugh, I don't know.
What is this? Look, the king is holding a pageant to find his next queen. Esther, you are more beautiful and graceful than any woman in Shushan. I think perhaps you should consider entering the pageant.
You can't be serious. I've never wanted to venture out of this tower, much less travel to the palace. Who knows what danger I might encounter? This all seems too sudden.
I understand your concerns, Esther, but please, take a seat and listen to me. This is not just about becoming the queen. It's about having an opportunity to influence the king's decision, to protect our people.
But how could I possibly do that?
Esther, I've unfortunately met Haman, one of the king's advisors. She's a dangerous woman who harbors ill will toward their people. If you could become queen, you could use your position to gather information, to keep an eye on her, and to protect her fellow Jews.
Do you really think I can do that?
I do, Esther. I have your best interests at heart. It's time to go outside, sweet Esther. Look at you, as strong as a rod, but a little timid and unsure. It's time to leave this giant tower.
But Morty.
Esther, you'll be safe and soundy. Time to face your doubts and venture forward. Time to show the world just who you are. Put aside your fear,
but
trust me, dear Mordecai knows best. Mordecai knows best. Listen to your uncle, you can do some good out there. Mordecai knows best. Take part in the pageant, you can win it all, I swear. Stand up tall now, you can kneel in my knees. Don't you worry, I'll be here.
But
you'll be great, cause everyone will love you. You can do it, just have faith. Esther, I'm here. Esther, I'll support you. Esther, here's what I suggest. Take a shower, leave this tower. Mordecai knows best. And I mean, it's practically a written invitation, just for you. How else is it coming through our tiny window over there?
A written invitation? I will do it, Mordecai. For our people, I will enter the pageant.
Oh, Esther, you're gonna be amazing. There's just one thing.
Yes?
Don't tell the king you're Jewish, at least not at first.
But I thought you said it would be safe for me, and that it could somehow help protect the Jews.
Yes, but let's take it one step at a time. You have to win the pageant first, and I think the safest way to do that is to keep your religion a secret for now.
Okay, I understand.
Great, let's get you ready for the king.
Let the pageant begin. Hi there, what's your name? My name's King Flynn. Nice to meet you.
Awesome.
You're a bit too high-pitched and furry for me. But can I have a hug?
Sure.
Thanks, Elmo. Sorry I didn't win. Bye, Elmo. Next. Hi there, what's your name? Welcome to the...
DJ, hit it!
Mr. E, tell me a much better version.
Arcadians long ago, conquered Sumer, took control, saw down living zombies in their chariots, they roll by the U, Rainy River, by the U, Rainy River, by the U, Rainy River, by the U, Rainy River.
You're right, no, you guys were awesome, but I'll think of the... You guys were awesome, but... Next! Hi there, you look a bit glum. What's wrong?
Well, my girlfriend Barbie just broke up with me.
I'm sorry.
Doesn't seem to matter what I do. I'm always the number two. No one knows how hard I try. Oh, I have feelings that I can't explain. Driving me insane. All my life been so polite, but I'll sleep alone tonight. Cause I'm just dead. Anywhere else I'm being attacked. Is it my destiny to live and die a life of wanting? I'm just dead. When I see love, she sees a friend. What will it take for her to see the man behind the tan and play for me?
Wow, that was beautiful. But you know this is a pageant for me to find my next queen, right?
Well, I thought maybe Barbie would be here. I guess she's not. Well,
I hope you find your girlfriend, ex-girlfriend. Next!
Snacks for Sam!
Hey, right here! Right here! Right here! Hey, here! Oh my gosh, what are you selling? Is it the floor products? Do you have a cup of drug elephant? Ew, who even says that? Anyways, where's Lululemon?
Yeah, that's not really what we're looking for. Thanks, anyways.
Oh, hey, King. You're looking old. Maybe you need some retinol.
You know what? It's so not crappy in here. Let's just go to Sephora.
What? Do you know who I am?
Who was that?
Janelle.
Ridiculous.
Next.
Wow. Finally, someone who looks like the purposely here for the pageant.
We're ready when you are.
Yo, this is Esther, stepping on stage in this Persian pageant where dreams engage. Got my head on straight with my heart so strong. In this competition where I belong. Among all the contestants, I stand tall, but it's more than looks. Gotta give it my all with Elmo so cute and Kenan's drive. In this competition, I will not hide. This is Esther's moment. Hear my voice in this pageant of queens. You'll make your choice with courage and grace. I'll seize the throne. Essence the queen, I'll make it known.
Wow, that was awesome. What's your name?
I'm Esther.
Esther, huh? I see you took me up on my random invitation.
Random book. Flynn, you're King of Clash by Roche? Why didn't you tell me?
Yeah, well, people look at me differently, plus it's hard to pronounce. They end up coughing, spitting, and sputtering, like Rabbi Cohen who doesn't get his kosher Mountain Dew in time. So, Flynn Rider was just easier. Hey, your hair is longer than I last saw you. It grows quickly, huh?
Yes, very. This is just from the journey here from the tower. So you're this good king making everyone happy, huh?
I certainly try, but rather just make you happy. So, what do you say? Do you want to be my queen?
I still can't even imagine what that would be.
Come on, it'll be great.
Thank you.
happen very quickly. You'd think they would go out on a date first or something. Anyway, the king has found his new queen, Esther. He must be so happy. You know who's not happy? Haman and Zeresh. They're still mad at Mordecai because he refuses to bow down to Haman.
Mordecai, how dare you defy my authority and not bow before me? I demand respect.
Haman, I will not bow before any mortal, no matter how high their position. I don't even bow down to the king. My allegiance is to our God, and I will not compromise my faith to anyone, not even for a woman as powerful as you.
You fool! You bring shame upon yourself and your people with your stubbornness. We will make you pay for this humiliation.
Haman, Zeresh, my people have faced danger throughout history, but we have always prevailed with faith and unity. Your threats will not deter us.
You will regret this, Mordecai. I won't rest until I see you and your people destroyed.
So, Bigton and Tyrus have reached a breaking point. Unfortunately, these two bumheads are up to some big trouble.
I can't take it anymore, Tarish. The king's demands grow more ridiculous by the day.
It's true. We've given our all to protect him, and what do we get in return? Nothing.
He never acknowledges our loyalty or our skills. We foiled assassination attempts, kept the palace secure, went with him on his secret adventures, got left behind and told no one, and yet he still treats us like common servants.
And don't even get me started on the way he flaunts his riches while we barely make enough to feed our families.
Seriously, and you know what? I'm not just some lowly servant. I can do more.
I know. Does he think the only things we could do are beat up people, sneak around, and bring him drinks?
You know, Tarish, I've never told anyone this, but...
Yes?
I've got a dream.
A dream?
Exactly. A dream that'll take me far away from this palace and the king's demands and needs. A dream that'll bring joy to many people, including us.
Wow, Big Tom. Tell me more.
I'm malicious and scary. My sneer could curdle dairy. And violence-wise, my hands are not the cleanest. But despite my evil look, and my temper, and my hook, I've always yearned to be a concert pianist. Can't you see me on the stage performing Mozart? People in the eye are so lately. Yep, I'd rather be called deadly. My killer shove too lightly. Cause way down deep inside I've got a dream.
He's got a dream. He's got a dream.
See, I ain't as cruel and vicious as I seem. Don't like to like breaking femurs. You can count me with the dreamers. Like everybody else I've got a dream.
La 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 la.
We've got scars and lumps and bruises,
but something here that oozes. Let's not even mention our complexion. But despite our extra toes and our goiters and our noses, we really wanna make a love connection. Can't you see me with this special little lady? Bowering in a robot down the street. But with some disgusting blighters, we're not lovers, we're not fighters. Cause right up deep inside we've got a dream. We've got a dream. They got a dream.
We've got a dream.
They got a dream.
And we know one day romance will reign supreme. Though our face leaves people screaming, there's a child behind it dreaming. Like everybody else, we've got a dream.
I would like to quit and be an actor.
I play baseball during my free time.
I swim in my downtime.
And my drawings are sublime.
I'm so skilled at softball.
I am good in shopping malls. And I can do this awesome karate kick.
I have dreams like you know, really. Just once I start to feel they mainly happen somewhere warm and sunny. On an island that I attend and rested and alone. Surrounded by enormous piles of money.
I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
I just wanna see my fellow do sexy
Baruch Hashem.
And with every passing hour, I'm so glad I left my tower. Like all you lovely folks, I've got a dream. I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
I've got a dream.
She's got a dream.
So
our differences ain't really that extreme.
Brutal success. I can't take it anymore, Terrace. We need to do something about this.
You're right, Big Tom. It's time the king sees our skills.
Let's show him what we're made of. Tomorrow night, we'll remind the king that he can't take us for granted anymore.
You mean?
Yes, Terrace. It's time we got rid of the king, once and for all.
To the king, finally getting what he deserves.
Okay, let's formulate a plan. So you know how King Flynn's allergic to chocolate? We'll steal some candy from Mystery's drawer.
Ooh, yeah, then we'll crush it up and slip it in his food tonight.
Totally. He'll never see it coming.
Well, well, well. Big Ton and Terrace think they have it all figured out. I don't know how the king won't taste the chocolate in his food, but, well, these two aren't exactly the sharpest tools in the shed, if you know what I mean. Still, we need to keep an eye on them. If someone else knew about their plan. Mordecai, how are you?
I've been better.
Wow, what's up?
You know Big Ton and Terrace?
The king's guards, sure.
They're planning to kill King Flynn.
King? Why?
I don't know. Something that had to do actual work. Millennials these days, I swear.
Oh my god, we have to tell someone.
I know, but we don't have any proof. It's all hearsay.
If only we had some proof. But it's not like they'd be dumb enough to... Oh my god! They wrote their plan out right here.
Wow, I knew these two Yentas were slow, but this is ridiculous. I have to go find Esther. She and Warren can Flynn.
Wait up, I need to do your hair.
Oh, of course, Aegon. My apologies. Here, let me sit down.
So, how's it going here at the palace?
Oh, well, I guess. I'm still getting used to everything. Big Ton and Terrace don't seem to like me very much, though.
Personally, those guys don't seem to like anyone very much.
That's good to know.
How are things with you and King Flynn?
Fine, I suppose. I mean, he's smart and kind, but I don't really know if he appreciates me yet, you know? I don't think he knows the real me.
Give it time. I'm sure sparks will fly soon.
Esther, I've been looking for you, and here you are right where I was a couple of minutes ago.
Hi, Mordecai. How are you?
Not great. I recently discovered some upsetting news. I need your help.
Of course. What happened?
It turned out Big Ton and Terrace are planning to kill King Flynn.
What?
You heard me. They're upset with the way he treats them, so they're planning to poison him with chocolate tonight. You have to warn the king.
Of course. Hey, guys. This will have to wait until later. I have to find King Flynn.
Do I get to do anyone's hair?
I always knew Big Ton and Terrace were underhanded, but I never thought it would come to this. I guess their last name isn't Stabbington for no reason. Luckily, it looks like Esther's going to save the day. Actually, it looks like she's going to save King Flynn. I just hope she can find them on time.
King Flynn, how are things with you and your new queen?
It's good, but you know, she's been away from all but like one person for her entire life. So you haven't quite connected like I would with someone else.
Doesn't leave you with a whole lot of room for adventure, does it?
It doesn't, but for some reason, I don't mind. Seeing her smile as she experiences new things, it's a new adventure for me too, you know?
Is that a spark right here?
I hope so. Check out her flowers. If so, how many dozen?
King Flynn, there you are. How's it going, sir?
How are you doing? I'm fine, thank you. What can I do for you?
Well, we were just having an evening snack, and we realized that we have some extra pudding. Please, let us share it with you.
Ooh, I just like pudding. What flavor is it? Strawberry. Yum. Thanks, guys. You're the best.
King Flynn, stop! Don't eat that!
Queen Esther, what's wrong?
These men are trying to poison you!
What?
Queen Esther, what do you mean?
They concocted a plan to slip chocolate into your food. It's most likely it was in that pudding right there.
Big Ton, Terrace, is this true?
Well,
I mean...
Answer me!
Yeah, we did.
I can't believe this. You two are supposed to be my trusted guards. We've been through so much together. You know what? Take them away.
Let's go.
No, don't take it!
I didn't finish my pudding!
Queen Esther, I don't know what I would have done without you. It's possible I wouldn't even be here anymore.
I'm so glad I could help.
You know, I wasn't sure how you really felt about me, especially getting caught up and seeing the real world for the first time, but after seeing how you stood up for me like that...
To be honest, my king, I don't really know how I felt about you until I thought I might lose you.
And now, how do you feel?
I feel like this is where I belong, right here with you.
I know exactly what you mean. All those days waiting for the right one. All those years struggling with him. All that time never even knowing the danger I was in. Now you're here blinking in the starlight. Now you're here and suddenly I see you. Standing here, it's all so clear, you're where you're meant to be.
And at last we see the light, and it's like the fog has lifted. And at last we see the light, and it's like the sky is blue. And it's warm. Getting long again.
Wait, I think it looks great.
That was a close one. Thank goodness Esther was there to warn King Flynn. And it looks like King Flynn and Esther are finally getting cozy. Maybe it will be smooth sailing from here.
Maximus, I couldn't sleep last night. I realized I didn't know the full story of the Stabbingtons.
What do you mean?
Well, I know Esther warned me about Bigton and Terrace, but how'd she know what was gonna happen?
Actually, it was her uncle Mordecai who uncovered the whole plot.
Really?
Indeed, Mordecai is the true hero here.
Wow, I should do something to honor him. But what?
Your Majesty, how are you doing? I heard about Bigton and Teresh.
I'm well, thank you. No worse for the wear. Come on, I'm glad you're here. I can actually use some counsel.
Yes?
What should be done for someone whom the king wishes to honor?
Who would the king wish to honor more than me?
Well, do you have any ideas?
Well, if I were the king, I would have that person give them a royal garment and a crown. I would have that person be paraded through City Square on a horse.
What a splendid idea. Hurry, take the garment and the horse, just as you have said, and do that for Mordecai.
Mordecai?
Yes, Mordecai. He's the one who uncovered the plot to kill me. I owe him my life.
But he...
Come on. These are my orders. Get them done at once.
Okay. Wretched Mordecai.
I know, Mordecai of all people.
Yeah, I should be the one receiving such an honor. Not that it's Jew. It's time we do something about all the Jews, once and for all.
Come on, you're right. But what?
We need to convince the king that the Jews are dangerous, evil people. Only then will he consent to getting rid of them.
Come on, you're absolutely right. And once that happens, it'll also ensure that Mordecai pays for his disrespect.
Exactly. We'll speak with the king tomorrow. Let's go work on our speech.
Thank you. King, you're good enough.
Why, yes, I am, Magic Mirror.
You're smart enough.
Thank you.
You look stunning today.
Thank you.
And gosh darn it, people love you.
Yes, they do, Magic Mirror. Thank you.
Your Majesty, I must speak with you at once.
Yes, I'm on. What is it?
Here in Xishan lives a group of people who defy your rule and disrespect our customs.
And undermine the greatness of your reign.
And who might these troublesome people be? Come on.
My king, they are the Jews, a people who stubbornly cling to their own laws and traditions, refusing to submit to your magnificence.
It's true, Your Highness, these Jews are dangerous.
And so, I present a solution, Your Majesty. A decree to annihilate all the Jews within your kingdom. This will ensure the end of their defiance and send a message to those who dare question your authority.
By royal decree of the king and his prime minister Haman, all citizens of Xushan are to annihilate, murder, and destroy all the Jews, young and old, men, women, and children alike, on the 13th of their calendar month, Adar.
You want to kill the Jews? Why, Haman?
Look at them, rude and unrefined, never bowing down to show respect. Know what I have in mind?
I do, but
that's right. We must keep Xushan safe and sound, King. Guess I always hoped this day was coming. Knew that soon you'd realize Jews are pests. I've got the thing. Shh. Trust me, King. Haman knows best. Haman knows best. Listen to your advisor, there are scary Jews out there. Haman knows best, one way or another, we must kill them all, I swear. They're a bunch of thugs, and they're disrespectful, scheming right behind your back.
No.
Yes, they are just like us, always such a handful. Xushan will be better off, King. Haman's right here, Haman will protect you. King, here's what I suggest. Skip to drama, stay with Haman. Haman knows best. Haman knows best. Listen to your advisor, with the Jews we won't survive. Doing their own thing, now the time to act for. Once they're gone, we will all thrive. Impolite, uncivil, positively graceless, surly and a bit, well, gross. Plus, we believe the rules are kind of baseless. We're just saying, cause we know them. Haman understands. Haman's here to help you. All I have is one request.
Yes?
Issue the edict to kill all the Jews.
Yes, Haman. I trust you very much, Haman.
I trust you more.
I trust you most. Take my ring and issue the decree.
Thank you, King Flynn. You're doing the right thing.
I can't believe it! The king has actually granted Haman the power to kill all Jews. This is a horrible, horrible day. If only someone could stop it.
Mordecai, there you are. I've been looking for you everywhere. Why do you look so troubled?
Esther, my dear niece, I feel we are running out of time.
What do you mean?
Didn't you see the king's edict?
No.
Haman has convinced King Flynn to kill all the Jews.
What? This can't be.
It's true. The situation in Xushan goes worse by the day. If Haman isn't stopped, all the Jews in Xushan will be killed.
Oh, Mordecai, but what can we do? I haven't seen the king in a month. I've been out experiencing so much. If I just barge in with an accusation like this, how will it look?
Esther, you are our only hope. You must find a way to speak to him. Tell him the truth, reveal your identity as a Jew.
Uncle, if I tell him this and he thinks it's a plot against him or worse, Haman already knows who I am and has him waiting for exactly this. It could seal our fate.
I understand the danger, Esther, but our people face annihilation. You are his queen. He loves you.
But Mordecai, I can't.
Look at you, as strong as a rod. Not a little sapling or a timid girl. You know why we only bow down to one God.
I know, but...
That's right. To keep you safe and sound, dear. Yes, I always knew this day was coming. Knew that Son Horiba would appear. Suddenly it's clear.
But
trust me, dear. Mordecai knows best. Mordecai knows best. Listen to your uncle. It's a scary world out there. Haman is a pest. One way or another, she will hurt the Jews, I swear.
Her family's full of thugs and the disrespectful scheming behind your back.
No.
Yes.
But
she is oh so smug. Always such a handful. Stop. Hesitation will upset me.
Mordecai's right here. Our God will protect you. Esther has what I suggest.
Stop the killing, Haman's chilling.
Do you not think you were placed in this position for a reason? Maybe it was Hashem that brought you into this palace. You must have faith in Hashem.
I know. You're right, Mordecai. I cannot stand idly by while my people suffer. But before I do anything, I need your guidance.
Esther, pray for strength and wisdom. Fast for 3 days. And on the third night, go to the king.
I will do the same, Mordecai. I will fast, I will go to the king. And I'll tell him that I'm holding a feast. Yes. That will give me the opportunity to tell him the truth about me.
Thank you, Esther. I know your courage will save us from this danger.
By your presence tonight. You have graced me with your company on this special occasion. But before we continue our festivities, I have something of great importance to share.
Esther, my queen, what is it?
My king, the truth I'm about to reveal has pained me deeply. This is a matter of life and death, not just for me, but for my people.
What could she possibly be talking about?
Doesn't matter, just ignore her.
I'm Jewish.
Oh my God!
Esther, you're Jewish?
Yes, I'm Jewish, as Mordecai is my uncle, and we are a part of the Jewish people.
My king, this is a lie. She's trying to deceive you.
Silence, Haman. I will hear what Queen Esther has to say.
My king, your trusted advisor, Haman, has devised an evil plan to annihilate my people, the Jews. She even cast lots to determine our day of destruction.
Haman, is this true?
This is a misunderstanding. I never intended any harm to Queen Esther or her people.
Mordecai, show the king of this evil woman's plot.
My king, this is a decree sealed by Haman, ordering the destruction of the Jewish people on this specific day.
Haman, you have deceived me and sought to destroy innocent people. Guards, seize her, and Zeresh too.
Let's make a run for it.
Ah! No! No! Get off!
Get off with me!
Never want to see them again.
My king, I beg of you, reverse this decree and save my people.
My dear queen, I shall issue a decree to protect your people. No harm shall befall them, and they shall be allowed to defend themselves against any who seek harm to them.
Thank you so much for your mercy and understanding.
And Mordechai, once again, you have proven yourself to be loyal, brave, and wise. If it's all right with you, I'd like you to be my new advisor.
It would be my honor.
Wait, I never found out who that new troublemaker was.
Oh, that was me the whole time.
I'm only taking apples from Queen Esther from now on.
Layahudim, Haita, Ora, Besimchava, Sasan, Vikar.
For the Jews, there was light, joy, gladness, and honor.
Thank you. All right, guys, let me thank a few people. First of all, I want to thank Mike and Micah, Duke, amazing custodian, for setting everything up. Thank you so much. Mrs. Ellie Knapp with the scenery. Matthew, give a big hand to Matthew with the light and the sound and everything. Also, I want to thank Miss Nicole. Where's Nicole Graham? Nicole Graham, are you here? The Hala, did you make that big Hala? Nicole Graham. And all the invitations and all that. Thank you, Miss Graham. Where's Paul Solomon? Where's Paul? There he is. Thank you, Mr. Solomon. We have confiscated his gym for about 3 months. He's great. All right, thank you. All the students who had the pregame show, give them a big hand. With Mariah, give Mariah a big hand. And Sam Crisco, the drummer, give her a big hand. Miss Manto, there's Miss Manto, the video and the shirts. See, all the Israel shirts and all the shirts. Thank you, Miss Manto. And I want to thank three amazing, talented writers, music, choreography, sound, behind the scenes, in the front, in the back. Let's start with Mr. Ilo. Where are you, Mr. Ilo? This is Sherry Swiss in the back. General Studies, Dr. Cheryl Baca. Now, don't nobody move. Do we have a drawing? Yes? Kahana Boyna? Do we have Ruth? Alyssa? Alyssa. Alyssa Engelberg. We have a winner. I hope it's me. Of course! I bought 5,000 tickets. Okay.
All right, we are announcing, because it's a day of lotteries, we're announcing the winner of the raffle to send these kids to Zion Park. All right. Zion! All right, I'm the witness. While we are going to run a raffle, if you bought a ticket, you'll find out now. All right, here we go. The winner. Oh, it's going, it's spinning. You guys excited? It's a Louis Vuitton. Number 41. Who is that? Anyone here 41? Lauren Nigerian! All right, let her know. All right. All right, someone let her know. We'll hold it for her. All right, thank you.
Thank you, everybody. I'll see you in our next show. Thank you, everybody. Good night. Thank you.